Israel have you been?
The holy city of Karbala.
Where else would you want to see each other other than Karbala?
Next to the shrine of Abu Abdullah Hussein, we have the honor.
True honor.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
You said, where else should we see each other? What does Karbala mean?
Karbala means the whole world. Karbala means karban wa bala. Karbala is all of Ahlul Bayt. But it reminds me a lot of Sayyidah Zainab and Imam al-Hussein salam Allah. They are the two characters that stand out in Karbala to me.
You came to Karbala for Muharram.
Yes.
Ashura.
Was yes.
It your first Ashura in Muharram or in Karbala? Or?
It was my first Ashura in Karbala, yes.
Do you sometimes think that nothing happens for no reason? That you were invited to be next to the Mawla Abu Abdullah al-Hussein?
That's with no question.
Why you? Why Abu Talib was invited this year? Do you ever ask yourself that question? Have you asked that yourself?
I wanted to be there. It was one of my hajjah that Abu Abdullah, you know, we say, Ya laytana kunna ma'akum. If we can't go back to the day of Ashura, 1400 odd years, then we come to Karbala and we can feel what happened in Karbala. So when I'm invited by Imam al-Hussein, I think I have the privilege to be there. And when I come back home, I urge others to go as well, so they understand more of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. Because when you enter the shrine of Abu Abdullah throughout the whole year, it's different. But in Muharram, you know that Abu Abdullah, you know, these minutes, these hours, they were the last hours you were present here.
A different feeling.
It does.
How did you spend Sham al-Ghariban?
Oh. I'm lost in words.
Sham al-Ghariban, and you lit a candle for Abu Abdullah al-Hussein. Why do you light candles?
Sham-e-Ghariban is Sayyidah Zainab. Sham-e-Ghariban is Sayyidah Zainab. You've taken me back.
You say the name Sayyidah Zainab with pain. What's the pain you feel here when you remember Sayyidah Zainab?
What did she experience other than pain? Was it the witnessing of her mother behind the door? Was it her father, Amir al-Mu'mineen? Or was it seeing her sons? Or was it seeing her brothers? Or was it seeing her beloved Hussein? Where? Where? Is it the day of Ashura when we say أنا ظليت حائرة وصف جبليدين لا عباس إبرالي ولا حسين؟ Where? Where? Tell me. I only think there is one point. And it's when she called Abu Abdullah, Hussein. Hussein. This is when Abu Abdullah came off his horse and he knelt down to her. And she said to him, oh, Abu Abdullah, I have an amana for you. Abu Abdullah, open your shirt for me. What's the amana? This is when she finally kissed Abu Abdullah between his chest and his neck. And she looked towards Medina, she said, Ummah, لقد أديت الأمانة. Mother, I have fulfilled your will. Ummah, you had one will, and it was for me to kiss Imam al-Hussein on behalf of you. I say, oh Fatima al-Zahra, if you were present on Ashura, what would have you done? Would you have worried for Hussein? Or would you have worried for Zainab, the one that ran between the tents? Would you worry for Hussein? Or would you worry for Abu al-Fadl? Would you worry for Hussein? Or would you worry for the companions of Abu Abdullah? How many messages do we pick up from Ashura? How many messages? We want to learn brotherhood? Ashura. We want to learn patience? Ashura. We want to learn Iman and Khuluq? Ashura. We want to learn Akhlaq? Ashura. We want to learn wisdom? Ashura. We want to learn Sadaqah? Ashura. We want to learn Karam? Ashura. Whatever you want to learn is Ashura.
Abu Talib, some people will recognize you when they're from obviously presenting the shows this year, reciting for us. But before this, you didn't change who Abu Talib was. Abu Talib was a khadim of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. Whether he was reciting on the pulpit, or whether he was in the kitchen, or whether he was in the Husayniyah, wherever you were, Abu Talib changed or did not change. He was the same Abu Talib. But they got to know you, alhamdulillah, through a show this year, or I should say last year, by the name of the Shia Voice.
Yes.
That's when Abu Talib was now Mullah Abu Talib. To many people. Many people said this, that you deserve this title. I want to take you back maybe to those that may not know you before these shows. How did you recite for Imam al-Hussein before these shows? Because I might be wrong, but I don't remember you reciting in public gatherings.
True. Right.
When did you start this recitation? Was it something that you would do at home? And it's a specific style that you recited.
Look, Sheikh Mustafa, for me to be called Mullah Abu Talib, it's too much. For me to be called Khadim al-Hussein Abu Talib, it's too much. I see myself as a servant to the servants of Imam al-Hussein. In Arabic we say, أنا خادم لخدام الحسين. Not to say, oh, I'm down to earth, oh, he's lines of poetry, no. For those that know me very well. And for those that don't know me, inshallah, will get to know me. And, you know, at times, there is some lines of poetry that touch your heart. And in the beginning, I said to you that Sayyida Zainab, you want to come to my heart? You say to me, Sayyida Zainab. You want to touch my heart? You say to Imam Hussein. Ahlul Bayt, they're all in my heart. But there's something else for Sayyida Zainab. There's something else for Imam al-Hussein. And Sayyida Zainab, there is one line of poetry says, أَنَا قَعِدْ بْنُ الصَّلِيلِ وَنْعِي وَنْعِي وَضُمَّنْ وَنِّتِي حَتَّى عَلَى السَّمْعِي. أنا قعد بنص الليل ونعي ونعي وضمن ونتي حتى على سمعي أبا عبد الله سيدة زينب says I sit in the middle of the night and I recite for you and I hum to myself but I even hide the humming to my hearing أبا عبد الله يا ابن الزهرة يا ابن الزهرة يا ابن الزهرة يا ابن الزهرة What do we have, Mullah? Sheikhna, what do we have other than Aba Abdullah? What do we have other than Hussein? When I stand in his shrine, I say to him, Abu Ali, ترى احنا معلقين بعبايتك. You know, at times you speak formally, but then it just You know, your mind cracks open and you say, Abu Abdullah, I hang on to your abaya. We have nothing. What do we have? What do we have other than Hussein? Huh? What do we have? Honestly speaking, what do we have? We hold on to Abu Abdullah. We serve Abu Abdullah. It's our dignity, our honor to serve wherever we can. And if it's not Abu Abdullah, then we are nothing. It's truly nothing. حسين رباني حسين كبرني حسين عرفني للآخرين إمام حسين he's the one that brought me up he is our father
he introduced me
وإلا who's أبو طالب who is أبو طالب it's not to honor for إمام الحسين that أبو طالب is known It's an honor for Abu Talib that through Imam al-Hussein he is known. It adds value to Abu Talib, not to Imam al-Hussein. Imam al-Hussein is up there. Who am I?
These are important points that you're mentioning because I think for the youth that maybe have missed the early Husseiniyah days, they missed this style of talking where people need to understand it's not about you when you're serving it's not about a video or a clip it's about serving Imam al-Hussein it's not about views it's not about numbers it's not about how many people attend the majlis it's not how many people we need to take all these things out and put it aside and listen to these words so people understand that the khidmah of Imam al-Hussein it's not about me it's about Imam al-Hussein alayhi afdal as-salatu wa salam you're taking people you're a vessel and you should be honored that you are
I am it's my honor and my dignity and it's my sharaf Imam al-Hussein as I said يعني, and I advise and recommend all the youth That's lots of people, they say, oh, wallah, we are jealous from you, mashallah, you can attend majalis and you can make it. It is tawfiq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes. It is tawfiq from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you serve Imam al-Hussein ma'a kull al-ikhlas, from open heart. When you're looking for cameras, you're not looking for people to say, oh, wallah, mashallah, he's done this. No. I always say it like this. I say we don't need Bluetooth. We don't need Wi-Fi. Directly work between the skies. Those that saw, saw, and those that didn't, let them not see. Al-yidri, wa-yidri, wal-maydri, la-yidri. For those that do know, jazahum Allah khair al-jazah. For those that don't know, they don't need to know. And there are multiple opportunities where the shabab, the youth, can join and take opportunity, take part. Because Imam al-Hussein, it's an ark of salvation.
Who instilled this love? How did, because obviously, it's important that we have this khidmah. But it is fitri to a certain extent.
Yes.
It is natural to a certain extent.
Yes.
But there needs to be seeds that are planted for this to come out. Each person, I think, in my opinion, humble opinion, inshallah, that each person that gets introduced to Imam al-Hussein alayhi afdhalus salatu wassalam will fall in love with him.
Yes.
Unless there's something wrong with your logic, your aql. That's put aside. But anyone that gets introduced to Imam al-Hussein will love him. So therefore it's there. But how do you ripen this love for Imam al-Hussein? So with you, how was this instilled in you?
I think it's something personal I will say. That my father's name is Hussein. And my mother's name is Zainab. So as much as I love my father, I see Imam al-Hussein. And as much as I love my mother, under the name of Sayyida Zainab, she's also named Zainab. And through life, through difficulties, I saw that whichever door you knocked, at times it will not open. It will reject you. But in the distance, there is a door. And it's the door of Abu Abdullah. When you knock that door, he opens it for you. And he opens it with wide hands open. He welcomes you. And when you enter it, you cannot leave. When you enter the love of Imam al-Hussein, you cannot leave back. You become an addict in the love of Imam al-Hussein. And let the haters hate, and let them say whatever they like. They have said in the past, and they will say in the future.
Doesn't change.
Imam al-Hussein, he is al-madallah. He shadows us. He's on top of us. No king, no wealthy, no poor, no power, no authority, no government. Imam al-Hussein is Imam al-Hussein. Shi'ta am abayt. He is there for us. And the more you serve Imam al-Hussein, the more Imam al-Hussein gives back to you. The more you give towards Imam al-Hussein, Imam al-Hussein gives back to you. You cannot give financially, go and serve yourself. You serve yourself, Imam al-Hussein gives you health. You support financially, Imam al-Hussein will give you back financially. You cannot attend the majlis, spread the word that the majlis is taking place. Imam al-Hussein will reward you for this. So you can serve in each and every aspect. Don't say, oh, wallah, ana majghool, ushagharat al-hayat, and I've got my wife and my kids, and I'm working 7 days, 9 to 5, 9 to 7, 12 hours a day. If you want to, you can. When you want to get Aba Abdullah Hussein, Hussein will be there for you. You said for those that fall in love with Imam al-Hussein. I speak to those that say Hussein 5 times from the bottom of their hearts. I want to say Hussein from the bottom of your heart. Forget everything. Close your eyes and say Hussein 5 times. If you didn't cry, there is something wrong with you. If you didn't cry, there's something wrong with you. And I'm responsible for what I say. But say Hussein min hurqat qalb, from a boiling heart, knowing that on the day of Ashura he was trampled upon by the horses. Knowing that Imam al-Hussein on the day of Ashura died of thirst, nobody quenched his thirst. Knowing that on the day of Ashura his body stayed under the sun 3 nights. We lose a loved one, especially in Iraq. They urge themselves as quick as possible for them to give him his resting place, the qabr. Your master Aba Abdullah stayed under the sun 3 nights. The sun will rise and go down upon Sayyid al-Shuhada. And yet on top of all of that, they question us, why do you cry, Aba Abdullah?
What does this khidmah mean to you? Would you give it up?
No. I've given up multiple things for khidmah. I've given up multiple things for khidmah. Multiple things. I've lost family members, I've lost friends, I've lost opportunities in life. But I took the best opportunity, it was Aba Abdullah's path. Multiple opportunities come in life. But Aba Abdullah never let go of him. And Aba Abdullah will never let go of you. You fall in difficulties, Aba Abdullah is there for you.
You've tried and tested.
You've Aba Abdullah, just, you can see the light behind you? You can see how bright the light is, you will see how doors will open for you. I have a aqeedah. At times you shouldn't say everything because the barakah of it goes. I have this aqeedah. But I think I've put the nuqat on the haruf.
Dots on the letters. You mentioned, and again, I'm sorry, but you are a mullah and you are a khadim al-Hussein.
I'm honored to be called khadim al-Hussein, and I am more honored to be called mullah.
On every person's tombstone, on their gravestone, they put their name. May Allah prolong your life in the service of Abu Abdullah Hussein. But what would you like? Would you like the words Khadim al-Hussein? Do you deserve, does Mullah Abu Talib deserve to be called Khadim al-Hussein? Have you done enough to be called Khadim al-Hussein? Because Khadim al-Hussein is Habib ibn Madahir. Khadim al-Hussein is Abis. Khadim al-Hussein is Burayr. Muslim ibn Awsaja. Do we deserve to have this title to be called Khadim al-Hussein? Has Abu Talib done enough? If Imam al-Hussein comes to you on your final moments, can you say, Aba Abdullah, I gave everything I can? Because khidmah, a service, is a, as you said, is a ni'mah. We must hold on to it. Today we have it. Maybe we're unfortunate we don't. Does Abu Talib deserve to be given the title of Khadim al-Hussein?
I would say, يا أبا عبد الله عذرنا من التقصير. We haven't done enough for Abu Abdullah. For what Abu Abdullah has done for us, what Abu Abdullah sacrificed for me, what Abu Abdullah sacrificed for his people, we haven't done enough. Abu Abdullah.
How was the day of Ashura in Karbala? When you woke up that day, sorry, I say woke up, you probably didn't sleep.
You didn't sleep that night.
But when the sun came out,
I wish the sun never rose. Even the son of Bint Rasulullah was going to be martyred, I wish the sun never rose. I say to myself, when we read ziyarat, say, Ya laytana kunna ma'akum sadati. Are we just saying this because it's written, or do we mean it from our hearts? It's important that we say, Ya laytana kunna ma'akum sadati, and we mean it. But if we don't mean it, then why do we say it?
Usually they say that when a na'i, someone that recites for Imam al-Hussein in a particular manner with a tune, as we know, when the reciters would recite next to the imams would just tell them, recite in the way you have, the lahn, the tar, the tune to make us cry. They say that when you recite, the na'i recites, a Sayyida Fatima alayha salam attends the majlis. We are in Karbala. Jannah on this earth. Paradise on this earth. Where Sayyid al-Shuhada was buried. No doubt, if you recite for us, Fatima will attend.
Salam Allah alayha.
So I want to end this episode that's been very emotional for us, and I'm sure for those watching.
with recitation, so we can have the blessings and the barakah to say that we recited and we mourned Aba Abdullah al-Husayn alayhi afdalus salatu wassalam. And we hope, insha'Allah, that as Sayyida Fatima alayhi salam can have her eyes on this recitation.
I would read two lines of poetry. One on behalf of Sayyida Zainab, and one on behalf of all the servants of Imam al-Husayn. يا علي طويل ساعتك يا علي احمل آهاتك يا علي ساعتك يا لي أحمل آهاتك لو ودعت الويليان تتولاني العدوان طول يا لأهل المواد شما تطول وياك ساهي أحسين بس هل يا ليمي ما تشوف عيوني باكي يا علي ارحم دلالي يا علي ضاقت امالي ولو ودعت الوينيان تتولاني العدوان دنيانا ظلام والخدمة ضوى دنيانا ظلام والخدمة ضوى الما يبكي حرام طبري تهوى الما عند حسين آخر تلوين تاليها يصير كسوة من حقي أهيم محبوبي رحيم ما يرضى يجي يمشي لهو ما حد مثل قلبه الحنين ورحمته عالسلة بخيام اختة تنزل دمعته عالسلة بخيام اختة تنزل دمعته حسين 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 يا حسين.